All right, everyone, how are you? My name is Jasbirizla. I am from Malaysia. So I've been I'm also a learning experience manager in a company. My background is engineering technology and also instructional technology. So my passion is in learning and development. All right. So now I have a question to everyone who is in the chat. Have you heard of the word octalysis before? You type 1 if you've seen, if you know what is octalysis, or 0. So how many of you know what is octalysis? Or F, have you heard of the word octalysis before? Okay, I can see in the chat a lot of you are saying 0.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. And I saw a few 1. Amazing. So in that case, for those who know what is octalysis, you can also be the facilitators in the chat, right? To help us fully understand what octalysis is all about. All right. So let's start with the, thank you so much. Thank you so much for all the engagement that I saw in the chat. So let's start with the title, Motivating Learners with Gamification in the Digital Age, or Octalysis Framework Strategies. So what we're looking at now is a framework on how to engage with people. So not just in e-learning, but also in other aspects of customer experience or learner experience. All right. So let's look at one, the definition of, first definition of gamification. Okay. So I really like to share this because I feel it's important for us to understand that gamification, there is a difference between gamification and game-based learning. All right. So gamification is taking elements in game to make your experience, to make customers, users, or learners' experience more engaging. So what I'm going to share today is about gamification. So game-based learning is using game for people to learn. For example, Minecraft. If you have kids and your kids are using Minecraft to learn how to build stuff, so that is game-based learning. And then you can also see, if you also use Duolingo, so that is game-based learning. So gamification is taking elements, all right? So that is something that we have to be clear about in this sharing session, right? Okay, if you have any question, you can put in the chat. Okay, so now this is what UK Chow founded in 2012. This 8 elements or 8 drives or core drives that could help people to be engaged in their experience of products of learning, all right, or in LMS or in whatever experience that you're designing. So he said that there are 8 things that usually help people to be engaged with. Number 1 is called epic meaning and calling. This is simple. So usually, for example, I like to play games. Usually when I want to play a game, there is a story behind it, right? So there is a reason why I'm playing this game. For example, if I'm playing Mario, it's because I want to save the princess, right? So that is the first one, epic meaning and calling. Okay, number 2, development and accomplishment. So it's about leveling. So if you go from one level to another level, you accomplish some things and you keep on leveling up. So that is also another drive on why people want to keep playing or with the game. All right. Number 3, empowerment and creativity and feedback. So that can be your profiles. For example, on Facebook, you have your own profile picture. You have to put your own profile picture. You tell your own story on Facebook. So that's empowerment of creativity and feedback. And when people likes your post, for example, that is part of empowerment of creativity and feedback. That's number 3. Number 4, ownership and possession. So this is when you collect points. right? So when you collect points, when you play games, if you want to earn as many coins as possible, and so on. So that is ownership and possession. Number five, social influence and relatedness, where you have collaboration between people, all right? Or you can chat with others within the platform. So that's social influence and relatedness. Number six, scarcity and impatience. So sometimes when I play a game, they say you have only 3 hearts and you lose the 3 hearts. Or if you have timer, then you are scared that it's going to end. So then that drives you to complete the game, all right? Number seven, unpredictability and curiosity. So when you want to know what's going to happen next, so then you start to think, okay, I have to complete level one in order to know what happens in level two. And then what happens if I do this? So that is unpredictability and curiosity. And the last one is called loss and avoidance. So this is when you don't want to lose something, so you try hard to keep it. So that is loss and avoidance. Okay, so one question to everyone. Have you seen 1 out of 1 to 8 in your workplace or in whatever you're doing, out of 1 to 8, which drive that you've seen the most? For example, in an LMS. In an LMS or something, which drive that you can see the most? Okay, good. Civilian X says number 3. Audrey, number 2. Development, accomplishment, empowerment. Number 2. Good, good. Yes, that's right. Number 2, you know, that's the easiest, perhaps. Number 3. Number 2 and 3. Okay. Thank you, thank you. So see, you are familiar with some of these core drives, right? But then we have been using the same drives, not knowing that there are at 8, like 7, 8 other ways that you can do to actually engage people or motivate people to stay in your platform or to stay in your learning experience, right? So I would like to do an activity with you where we can go to this one platform that I think everyone know. So okay, if you could, if the moderator could help share with the participants the picture of this Octalysis, the 8 Octalysis, so that we can do our small discussion. Okay, so I want to go to Netflix. Okay, so let's go to Netflix and see why is Netflix so engaging for some people. All right, and why do we keep going back? What are the 7 or what are the elements that they have, gamification elements that they have that could be implemented in our LMS? You see, so you have it. If you click the link in the chat, you can see the 8 Octalysis Octalysis drives. So then you can help me figure out from Netflix which core drives are we looking at, right? So number 1 is this. Continue watching. So what do you think about this continue watching core drives? What is the core drive? Okay, some say it's number 2. Some saying it's number 7 or number 5. 7, very good. 7, 5. So 7, unpredictability and curiosity. Not yet. 5, social influence and relatedness, maybe. But I'm talking about this. Continue watching. Number 8, number 3. Empowerment, development and accomplishment, Feedback, yes. Number three, yes. And also, number four, very good. Number four, okay. So continue watching. Remember, it's something that you watch, right? So what happens if I change this profile and or somebody else is using your profile to watch what they have? What happens is the continue watching will change, right? So it's somewhat talking about your personal preferences, okay? So it's your personal preferences, ownership and possession. Very good. I saw a lot of four and three. So continue watching is part of what do you call number four core drive, which is part of your own ownership. You know, you want to make sure that you don't lose it, because you know you will be angry about it if you do not go back to the thing that you want to watch. All right. So, and interestingly, Netflix also do suggestions, right? So they do suggestions. If I go to more info, so what about suggestions? Which one? If Netflix does suggestions, which core drive are we talking about? Suggestion. When it comes to suggestion, which one, which core drive it is? Number five, social influence and relatedness. Good. Why do you think it's number five? Why do you think it's relatedness and social influence? Unpredictability. Okay. This is interesting. Unpredictability and curiosity. Why do you think it's unpredictability? Next. Why do you think it's number seven?
Let's ask that, and the audience, feel free to write that in the chat. It's absolutely okay. Share your comments. There might be a little delay of 5 to 7 seconds, but we'll get there eventually.
Yep, thank you. So why do you think it's number seven? Number seven says it's unpredictability and curiosity. But you have to know that Netflix... Yes. So it's not so much unpredictability, right? Because they actually read your algorithms and suggest whatever you like, right? Okay, very good, Vilula. So it makes you curious, you want to come back for more. Yes, that could be. Yeah. Instead of looking something to watch, want to see, they might suggest to you, yes. So they usually would suggest something that you have been watching, right? So that is also and then your curiosity is number seven, because then you are curious, okay, this might be something that I like, so it's number seven. Okay, so there's another one, last one, my list. This is easy. My list, you have your own list. So my list. I don't know if you noticed. Yes, my list is number four. My list. Four. Ownership and possession. Yes, it's your own. But I don't know if you noticed, there is also recently, there's this... a question mark anywhere in one of the row. So they put a question mark. You see, even Netflix, a platform that has already been viewed by millions of people, they would keep on making it more engaging over time, right? So recently I saw, recently I saw there's this question mark. So they would have question mark anywhere in the row. So my kid would just ask me to click it just to see what's inside as a surprise. So that is purely number seven, which is curiosity, where a platform actually use this gamification technique to help to make sure that people are coming back to the platform, right? So that is it for the definition. If you have any questions, you can write it in the chat. Okay, so we have a few minutes left. I would like to also share with you one example that I have created using this iSpring page where I want to show you the difference between a normal learning experience with a learning experience with gamification. Okay? All right? So if you're ready. Okay. So there, this is a course that I call an empathy. So for example, I'm a teacher. I would like to teach empathy to my students. So what I've done is I've created this course like a normal course. I title it as empathy. I put the introduction. So I put lesson one, what is empathy? I put element of empathy. And so on. So if you can see here, even in iSpring page, this progress bar is also part of gamification, right? So I find this very useful. So now as a teacher, I keep on going until I go to lesson three as the conclusion. Okay, so now I'm a teacher that has learned about gamification. I would like to change my style. Okay, so I'm changing my style to, and I'm changing the way I deliver my learning experience. So let's see. Okay, so instead of titling my module as empathy, I put it as the empathy journey, number one. Okay. So my plan is to slowly bring you throughout this learning experience. Okay. So towards this, the end of this presentation, let me know what's the difference and what have I done to this new module, right? So first, I asked this question. Do you know the differences between empathy and sympathy? Okay. Right. Then I move on to this popular video.
So what is empathy and why is it very different than sympathy? Empathy fuels connection. Sympathy drives disconnection. Empathy, it's very interesting. Teresa Wiseman is a nursing scholar who studied professions, very diverse professions where empathy is relevant, and came up with four qualities of empathy. Perspective taking, the ability to take the perspective of another person or recognize their perspective as their truth. Staying out of judgment. Not easy when you enjoy it as much as most of us do. Recognizing emotion in other people and then communicating that. Empathy is feeling with people. And to me, I always think of empathy as this kind of sacred space when someone's kind of in a deep hole and they shout out from the bottom and they say, I'm stuck, it's dark, I'm overwhelmed. And then we look and we say, hey, you can climb down. I know what it's like down here, and you're not alone. Sympathy is, ooh, it's bad, uh-huh. No, you want a sandwich? Empathy is a choice, and it's a vulnerable choice, because in order to connect with you, I have to connect with something in myself that knows that feeling. Rarely, if ever, does an empathic response begin with at least. And we do it all the time. Because you know what? Someone just shared something with us that's incredibly painful, and we're trying to silver lining it. I don't think that's a verb, but I'm using it as one. we're trying to put the silver lining around it. So I had a miscarriage. Oh, at least you know you can get pregnant. I think my marriage is falling apart. At least you have a marriage. John's getting kicked out of school. At least Sarah is an A student. But one of the things we do sometimes in the face of very difficult conversations is we try to make things better. If I share something with you that's very difficult, I'd rather you say, I don't even know what to say right now. I'm just so glad you told me. Because the truth is, rarely can a response make something better. What makes something better is connection.
Okay. So, when you watch this movie, when you watch this video, is it fit? How do you feel? Do you feel more connected to the content or not? You see? Thank you, Christina. So, yep. Just answering Audrey's question, it's iSpring page. So when you watch this movie, compare it with the course that I showed just now, the sample course on empathy. What are the differences? Where is the gamification drives that makes you keep watching? More connected. Yes, very good. You see? So that is only a few minutes of just a few minutes of my presentation, where you go from this dry content to a more engaging one. So let's go down deeper and let's discuss this. What are the gamification aspects that I use or elements that I have used to make it more engaging? All right. So yes, humor with education connected. It's actually humor, narratives are all within gamification is the epic meaning. So it's a storytelling. So storytelling gives an impact to the way you deliver your message, right? So in this module, I start with a question. Do you know the differences between empathy and sympathy? So which gamification drive that make you want to go to the next slide? Which gamification? It's actually, right? Curiosity, right? Yes. So first you start with a question and then you go down and you start to share a story. So that is core drive number one, epic meaning. So when people are connected to your story, they started to find meaning, right? They started to find their own meaning or make their own meaning and understand, right? Okay, so then you slowly go down to the slides and start giving more like bits and pieces, and then you start building this a story that helps people to keep on connected to your message. Okay, so which one, in your opinion, is more engaging to your learners? Is it the first course or the second one? Okay. Yes, 7 and 1, Jamila. 5. Okay. And then you have steps, and then you start teaching them. And then you start going back to what you want them to know. And then you share another short video, and then you start questioning them. So when people are more engaged, they take it personally, right? They take it because it's emotion. So when you touch people's emotions, they start to remember. So that is what gamification is all about. It's the 8 core drives that help people to feel connected. So it doesn't have to be all 8 core drives. You don't have to insert all 8 core drives. Even in this page alone, it has the track bar, which is one of the core drives already, where you can see achievement, you can track your progress, and then you have this story, which is in one page, and then people can scroll down. And so all this add up and making it a journey that people want to keep on going. Okay? So yes, they are more involved. Once you create a learning experience within using this gamification framework or the Octalysis framework, it helps people to be more engaged and keep wanting to go back, not knowing why I'm going back, you know, what keep me going back to this place. So it's because you engage them or connect with them. Okay. So
Jasbirizla, I'm so sorry to interrupt here. Yes. I have about a couple of minutes left for this session. So.
Yes. So can you, if you have any questions, so I think this is the time for you to ask. Mm-hmm. Any questions from the audience?
So far, it feels like everybody was so engaged with the story and the example that you were sharing. So people didn't really have a chance to write any questions if they had. So okay. Yeah, they were mostly reacting to what they saw interacting with you, which is amazing. So I think give them a little minute to formulate the question and just maybe proceed to some conclusions.
Okay. All right. So this is what I have so far. So it's the 8 core drives. And if you want to connect with me, then you can go to my LinkedIn. You can ask any questions. So like I said, you don't have to tackle each one, but you can have piece of pieces and create a meaningful learning experience.
Mm-hmm. I think
very good comments I saw. Do you have additional examples of each of the 8 core drives? In my there is a extra resources that I shared with you, the slide deck. So in there is this I've also shared this gamification in e-learning design, where you can download the presentation. I have a few examples in there with the explanation. I hope that's helping you, Kara. And the elements of gamification can be thought of transforming learning from feeling like a chore to something fun. Yeah, yeah, and impactful. I really do. I loved it. Okay, good, Teresa. Good to know that you want to use this. Thank you, Laura. Thank you, Kara.
Okay, perfect. Can I ask a quick question that was yes. Among the first ones on top, maybe because there was a full list of comments and compliments. Last point is, how can you quickly find such videos as illustrations for your courses? Is there any life hack that you can give?
Okay, so this is my personal tips. I've been doing instructional designing for a long time, so I like to watch movies. So because of it, I like to watch movies, my way of storytelling is always I would always start with a question, and then you go deep into the feelings, and then you go back up. I don't know how to explain this, but that's how I do. Whenever I do a storytelling, that's how my brain works. So basically, I hope it helps. So I watch a lot of movies, so that movies, the way directors narrate these stories help to build also my learning experiences.
Great. Thank you so very much. Is there anything else you'd like to say as a concluding phrase to our participants?
I hope you get inspired and then start transforming your learning experience. I think, yeah. Thank you.
A lot of people will, I'm sure, because they're sharing in the comments that they certainly want to use that model, and they thank you so very much for that. Thank you. Thank you so very much.